So I'm going to change the question from what is the next big question to what is the next small question. And the reason I think it's fair to do this is because in information technology, we're not about next big thing, because you don't want your new cell phone to be twice as big as your old one. You want it to be smaller. The world around us is made of atoms, and the quantum behavior of atoms determines the way the world works. The quantum nature of atoms and of light determine why the sky is blue and why leaves are green, why we use copper to make electrical wires and oil as fuel, and not the other way around. All of this is based on the chemical properties of molecules and atoms and light and so on. And by studying quantum mechanics, getting a better understanding of quantum mechanics, we can get a better understanding of how the world works. And by studying quantum computing, we can get a better understanding of quantum mechanics. And again, get a better understanding of the world around us. I don't really see what can be a bigger question than that.
So in terms of a census of what's in the universe, basically the atoms, the stuff that we are made out of, makes up only about 4%. And that's the only part of the universe we actually understand. The rest, this dark matter, we don't know what it is. And this dark energy that has really come to the fore only in the last few years represents the vast majority of the energy in the universe. So one of the big questions that we're trying to answer in the Gravity Cosmology Program is what comprises 96% of the universe.
In 1989, the communist regimes of Eastern Europe fell one after the other in a set of developments so dramatic that some describe them as the end of history. Many people expected lifespans in these countries to increase as new freedoms and opportunities became available. But consider this. After the transition, male life expectancy in the Czech Republic increased by 272 years by 2001. The very same year in Russia, male life expectancy dropped to barely 59 years. It was not only about alcohol. So that's a difference of 13 years of life on average per man. You would not see that kind of discrepancy between two societies if one had a cure for cancer and the other didn't. So my point is that answering the question, what makes a society successful, has an impact on the length and quality of life for people around the world. The difference between a successful society and an unsuccessful society can be as important as any medical or technological breakthrough.
And I would submit that perhaps there's no more important question for people to solve than the nature of the human mind. The key thing here, then, in terms of how you develop a mind, is how it is that you get rid of stuff. How is it you throw away half of the brain? What are the events that lead to that? And that really leads to the fundamental question that we're asking, and that is, how does experience get under the skin to sculpt this brain into the marvelous thing that we use?
Brain development is an active process. It's influenced by a wide range of factors in life success, whether it's measured in social economic status, in health, in happiness, in the number of microbes, whatever, is a profoundly, actually it's an interesting question as to whether that's the case, is profoundly affected by these factors. And I'm suggesting to you that managing the way in which these kids develop is a life insurance policy that you can only buy once, and that's early in life. And that's really the key to understanding how it is that we are who we are. Thank you.